This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about Microsoft Threat Protection. You may have seen it recently in the news. But Microsoft Threat Protection isn't just one thing, it's actually four things. First off, it's Microsoft Defender ATP, Advanced Threat Protection. And you can think of that as a super duper antivirus as well as a cloud tracking system. Then it's also Azure ATP, which can be used to track threats and things on your domain controllers. Microsoft Cloud App Security, which delves deep into cloud applications, into where users in your office use cloud pieces that they aren't authorized to use. And then, of course, the piece that probably most people are aware of is the Office 365 Advanced Threat Protection. I'll recommend that you review the Microsoft 365 licensing guidance for security and compliance. It can be a little confusing to use Microsoft Threat Protection, mainly because sometimes it will open up a console or a view for everybody in your office, and you've only licensed some people in your office. So obviously you have to narrow the scope down in the console of exactly those people that are licensed for the product, not for everybody in the office. One of the things I'm a fan of in the Microsoft Defender Security Center is this timeline feature. And especially for, heaven forbid, if we should ever have ransomware, it shows you the actions that are going on inside your system. And because this is a cloud service, obviously if, worst case scenario, a ransomware attack has encrypted your devices and so you can't get into log files, all of this information is up in a cloud service that you can still look at. So if you need to come back in after the fact and go, hey, what happened? What attack really came through my system? Because these log files are up in the cloud system, you can come back and see what went on. I'm also a huge fan of the Threat Center that's up on Microsoft Defender because it analyzes typical attacks and how they might come into your system and give a step-by-step how these attacks occur. So it helps me understand in my environment what might be happening and what might come in. So this is what's called the MITRE attack sequence, and it shows you how TrickBot came in and what protections you might have along the way. And I look at that and go, hey, do I have everything in place to protect myself? And remember, you can sign up for a trial for the Microsoft Defender Advanced Threat Protection. And you can come out here and go through simulations and tutorials. So obviously, you don't want to infect your own machine with ransomware or some kind of investigation attack. But you can come out here and get simulation files that drop backdoors or PowerShell scripts so you can see what would go on and what kind of things and information you'd get provided. Next up in the Microsoft Threat Protection bundle is Office 365 ATP. I'd say this is the best known of the bunch. Most of you either have had it or wish you have it. And it includes the anti-phishing, safe attachments, safe links, enhanced filtering, and all sorts of other techniques to allow the user to be best protected. I highly recommend, even if you don't have Office 365 ATP, that you have some sort of filter between you and the outside world. Phishing attacks is huge these days. This is how the attackers are coming in. So if you don't have something out here that is checking those attachments, checking those links, making sure that you don't get impersonation and spoofing, you are a sitting duck for attacks. So make sure you have something between you and that email client. The next one up is Cloud App Security. And what this is about is looking for cloud applications or other unusual IT software that you didn't authorize in your firm. So it lets you, you can also upload traffic logs from your firewalls. You have to convert them. You have to specially put them in a certain format, and you upload them to the cloud app securely, and it analyzes it to see what's going on. It lets you know if there's different applications that people are using that they shouldn't be. You can also set up infrequent travel alerts. In my example here, I set up a suspicious inbox forwarding. I set up a forward from an admin box outside to an external email, and it alerts me when that occurs, and it actually blocks the activity. So you can set up all sorts of policies to say, hey, if somebody logs in from an unusual location, I need to be alerted, I need to be blocked. If somebody does what's called impossible travel, where suddenly they log in from Los Angeles and then the next thing you know, they're logging in from Paris, France, they can't just immediately pop over to Paris. There's probably an attack going on, so let's log that down and lock down that machine as a result. The final piece, and probably the least well-known, I would say, of the four, is Azure Advanced Threat Protection. And it's not just for cloud assets. You can actually let it look at your on-premise domain as well. You can have it integrate in with your Defender ATP endpoints. You can have it review what's going on in your VPN connections, really important these days with more and more people working from home. And then finally, you can hook it into your Active Directory and actually set up a managed service account on your domain controller and look for unusual activity going on. For example, the default scheduled reports are going to tell you when there's modification to sensitive groups in Active Directory. It's going to tell you if you're exposing LDAP authentications, basically exposing your user passwords and clear text across your domain. And last but not, and certainly not least, and more important, it's going to show you when there's lateral movements to sensitive accounts, meaning that those local passwords are being cracked or harvested by an attacker and they're doing lateral movement across your network. So as you can see, this is kind of doing a holistic view of your entire network, all the way from the workstations to your email, to your domain controllers, to your cloud assets. And think in terms of what your current security solutions are doing for you. Do you have something similar? Ask your vendors what they have available to you as well. I'll be touching more on Azure security in future episodes. I've just done the top of the iceberg here. And until next time, please make sure you come out to the YouTube channel, Tech Talk from IDG, for lots more news of the day. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.